My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, Jesus Christ, our Lord, did not leave anything he himself wrote, nor did he command his disciples to write down his teachings. What we know of Jesus from the Gospel and other New Testament writings came from what was remembered, reflected upon, and transmitted by witnesses from the beginning and the ministers of the world. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the first preaching about Jesus centers on his identity as a Savior and Messiah by virtue of his resurrection from the dead. Here he is clearly revealed as the Son of God. Then as people came to believe and were baptized in his name, their wish to know him more deeply, inspired by the preaching of his teachings and his deeds, and believers came to know Jesus in a backwards direction from the culminating points of his ministry, his passion, death, and resurrection, and then to the beginning of his ministry at his baptism by John, and finally to his birth and childhood. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, when the evangelists wrote the Gospels, it was not only to preserve what Jesus taught and did, but also to enlighten believers in their living of the Christian faith. Words and deeds of Jesus that could serve as inspiration or enlightenment in the life situation of Christians were early recalled. When Matthew was writing his gospel, the good news of salvation was already being preached, first to Israel and then to the other nations, that is, the pagans. The proclamation was met by two kinds of responses. Some believed and came to worship the exalted Jesus. Others rejected the message. While the apostles and the early believers were Israelites, the Jews as a people did not accept Jesus as the Messiah, but many of the pagans did. My dear brothers and sisters, Matthew looks back to the childhood of Jesus with this post-resurrectional hindsight. This is clear in the story of the Magi, or the wise men from the East, who came to Jerusalem to pay homage to the newborn king of the Jews. In Matthew's mind, they represent the pagan peoples who would come to believe in Jesus when the apostles would proclaim him as the Savior after his resurrection. The pagans, deprived of sacred scriptures, have knowledge of God only through nature. And so the Magi receive a revelation through astrology. But this is not enough to lead them to where the Messiah is to be found. The ultimate secret is locked in the scriptures of Israel, that is, in the oracle of Micah. And yet, paradoxically, those who have the scriptures, the Israelites, and who can see plainly what the prophets had said, do not worship the Messiah. On the contrary, Herod and other religious leaders conspired against him. On the other hand, the pagans, with the help of scriptures, find and adore Him. My dear brothers and sisters, the story of the Magi or the wise men, therefore, is a miniature gospel. Already, it presents Jesus as a sign that is contradicted, a cause for the fall of some, but the rise of others, as a Simeon prophesies in him. Many in Israel and many of the well-born among the Gentiles will not accept him. But what is hidden to the wise, the clever, and the well-born, God chooses to reveal to the humble and those from far off. In the words of Paul, God chose the lowly and despised of the world, those who count for nothing, to reduce to nothing those who are something, so that no human being might boast before God. My dear brothers and sisters, the solemnity of the Epiphany elicits in us praise and thanksgiving to God, who has revealed in His Son to all, on no merit on the part of any. The revelation to the Magi is a sign that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in Christ Jesus through the gospel. My dear brothers and sisters, this day the Lord will manifest Himself in a small way, in a small piece of bread, in a quiet inner voice, in the conscience, in the simple loving gesture of a companion. What we see will depend on our faith, on what we believe. As the first reading tells us, though night still covers the earth and darkness the peoples, above you the Lord now rises, and above you His glory appears. The one who prays knows the sun is present even when it is cloudy. Let us be sensitive to the manifestations of God's love this day. May we rely more and more on what God sees, and may listening to His words give us a stronger vision of faith. In this way, our lives too can be an epiphany, a manifestation of God's love for His people. Many have not discovered the love of God. The feast of today is a reminder that God's light, life, love are for all people. God wants His love to reach the all people. Each one of us can share in this great task and mission. We too are called to be lights. Jesus needs you to be an epiphany or manifestation of His love. Go for it. Don't let anyone stop you. There are many Herods who will try to get in the way. But keep your eyes fixed, focus on Christ, and stay away from Herods. Like the Magi, the wise men did. They really were wise because they were warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, so that went home another way. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, Jesus is telling us in this feast, be an epiphany of my love to all. We can respond, Jesus, increase my faith. Help me to listen to your words and believe it, so that my life can be a bright and shining epiphany of your love. Amen.